النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said من حفظ 10 آيات من أول سورة الكهف عصم من الدجال. Anyone who memorizes 10 آيات from the beginning of سورة الكهف will be protected from the fitna of الدجال. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said فمن أدركه. Anyone who lives until the time of the emergence of الدجال and meets him فليقرأ عليه فواتيح سورة الكهف. Then let him recite upon him the opening ayat of سورة الكهف. فإنها جواركم من فتنته. Because that will save you from his fitna. الله أكبر. And so you need to ponder over these 10 ayat. What's in them that will save us? What's in them? The very beginning of سورة الكهف, how does it begin? الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب. Meaning the Quran is going to save you. And Allah Azza wa Jal said, أنزل على عبده الكتاب. Allah revealed upon his slave the book. Allah did not say, الحمد لله الذي أنزل القرآن ولم يجعل له عوجا. أنزل على عبده. He revealed the Quran on his slave, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Why? النبي صلى الله Allah is teaching us, it is impossible for you to take this Quran without the guidance of النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. You can only take it from his mouth and from his teachings. Anyone who wants the distance between the Quran and Sunnah al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a disbeliever. He has fallen into a great fitna. These two things are tied, they are one. You can only understand the Quran according to how al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam understood it. Then and only it will guide you. And if you understand the Quran separate to the understanding of al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions, then wallahi, the Quran, which is the book of guidance, will become the greatest source of misguidance for you. Yes, yes, the Quran becomes a source of misguidance. Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, يُضِلُّ بِهِ كَثِيرًا. Allah misguides many with the Quran. How? When you want to understand it according to your own desire. And say, I don't care about what Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said and what the companions said.